It wasn't physical. It's no problem with me going to the fitness club or going to rehab or even going to the gym. Like, that was kind of an outlet and an easy part for me was mental. Because first you have to deal with the injury, then the surgery, and then the whole rehab process, which is grueling. I mean, it's grueling, and you have to do everything right or you're gonna have major setbacks. And for the last 3 or 4 months, I've been fine. I got past that part, and then here we hit a snag in the business side where I'm physically fine. I'm building my fans up for the return, and then all of a sudden, nothing, because we have these issues internally going on. And that was frustrating. But like you said, man, this is when the things that you talk about, the things that you preach, you have to live them out. And, you know, I had to turn to God and buckle down, man, and stay prayerful. And stay, you know, just even my church family and just people, my pastor, Pastor Napoleon Kaufman, my wife, like certain people, you know, just held me down during this time, because it's tough. You don't have a bunch of fans cheering you on. You don't have these cameras. There's no fight coming up. So you have to find a resolve somewhere. And I found it in my faith in God, and I found it in my family and the people that were around me. But again, I don't look at that like it's a bad thing. That's part of what makes me, and that you're going to see all of that November 16th. Like, Lou's talking about motivation, and don't get me wrong, Edwin has a tremendous story, him and his wife, and that's motivation, something I don't know about. But I have my own set of motivation, certain things that maybe I liked or didn't like that went on in these negotiations. And it's not personal, but I have to pull from that. That fuels me. A lot of people say, oh, you look really slim and you look trim, because I've been working. I haven't been sitting around feeling sorry for myself, getting 20 pounds. I've been living like a fighter, living like a professional athlete, because I knew at some point these negotiations are going to get finished and then we're going to get the call. And this got solidified maybe 2 weeks ago. But just think, if I wasn't training and then all of a sudden we get a 9-week call, we could probably get in shape, but I wouldn't be at my best. I'm ready now. I got a foundation. Now we just got to build on and step it up, and we're going to be ready to go November
16th. I got one more question. Andre, the commentator's got to go.
And more or less, you know, what was promised on your part, and do you have an option if, you know, those promises aren't met, that you could go and seek another representation?
No, it's just, I know what I've accomplished in the sport. And it's hard for me to talk about myself. Well, I'm not going to brag about myself. I try to be a realist.
Grounded.
I try to be a realist. But I know what I've accomplished. I know what I've accomplished. And I feel like I know what I deserve. And I know what he's accomplished. He doesn't have a title. He's coming off of the Super Four, whatever it was called, tournament. He's got to, you know, coming off a big one. But the credentials aren't there to demand what you're demanding. So I'm not one of those fighters that just says, hey, what's the number? Okay, I'll accept that. Let's go fight. I understand that I'm one injury away from things being over.